So this is something we will try to avoid by taking good care of our hearts. We need to purify the heart. We need to perfect it. We need to cultivate it. We need to take very good care of it. And then we will be, and only then, we will be able to see the reality of things. We will be able to call a spade, because we will be able to see it as it really is, without any distortion and without any blurred vision. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He talks about the people who will also end up in the hellfire, in a very beautiful surah, the surah of Al-Mutaffifin, those people who do not observe justice when they buy and sell, Allah says about them, "Kalla," because they say about the Quran, "Asatirul Awwalin." They say these are the fairy tales, these are the imaginary tales of the ancient nations. Allah says about these people, "Kalla, bal rana ala qulubihim ma kanu yaksibun." Why? Why do you think they are unable to see the reality of the Quran? Because everything in the Quran is an evidence that these words are from the Creator of the heavens and the earth. These words can only be from Allah, the only true God. Why are these people unable to see this reality, despite being so obvious and so evident? Allah says, "Kalla bal rana ala qulubihim ma kanu yaksibun." The reason is their sins, their misconceptions, their evil intentions, the evil things they've been doing so far have made or have created a screen. They have created some kind of a veil over the hearts, so the heart cannot see the reality of things. The heart does not have a clear image of the reality, so they cannot see the truth. And this is something that I believe most of us experience on a personal level. Sometimes people who are very dear to you, you see the truth about a sunnah from the Prophet ﷺ, about one of the aspects of one of the articles of faith in Islam, and you try to explain it to them. You tell them, you know, what you are doing is wrong. It displeases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It incurs the anger of Allah. So you should avoid that. And you bring the proof from the Quran, from the Sunnah, and even from the logical point of view. And it's so obvious that it doesn't need any further evidence. But still they cannot see it. And you feel desperate. You feel disappointed. You know, because these people really mean a lot to you. You're concerned with them. You want them to see the truth, but they can't see it. The reason? كَلَّا بَلْ رَانَ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ مَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. There's a screen, there is a veil over the hearts, so that really prevents them from seeing or from having a clear vision, from seeing the reality of things. So by this, and this is another evidence that the faculty of comprehension, the faculty of understanding is in reality in the heart. The heart sees the reality of things. It either has a clear image of the reality of things, or it has a blemished image of the reality of things. So this is another reason that really made us dedicate a whole show about the heart and its secrets, the rules that govern this mysterious world. I'm saying mysterious because unfortunately most people have distanced themselves from this beautiful world. Whereas the main focus should be on the heart. The real life is the life of the heart. Because with the heart being dead, life means nothing. Not only in the hereafter, but even in this world. And don't forget the verse that we have quoted often, that Allah says on about the Day of Judgment, on that day wealth, offspring, anything you have achieved, will be of no avail. The only thing that will be of benefit is a sound and intact heart. This is the only thing that will enter people into paradise. So this is why we have to focus on our hearts. We have to see the reality of this world through our hearts. So we have to purify the hearts. We have to polish our hearts from inside. We have to clean our hearts So our heart becomes a very clear mirror, a very clear reflection of the reality of things. And this is why the people of Iman have always had a very strong sense of intuition. It is narrated about some great scholars of Islam, like a Shafi'i. He would see a person walking in the streets and he was able to tell where he came from, which country he comes from, and how long he's been here in this country, and why he came to this city for. What's the reason he came to this city? Without speaking to him, without seeing any further details. Why do you think this is the case? It's been proven authentically that the Prophet ﷺ said, اتَّقُوا فِرَاسَةَ الْمُؤْمِنِ. Be careful, be aware of the intuition of a believer. But the later part of the hadith, which is very widespread, فَإِنَّهُ يَنْظُرُ بِنُورِ اللَّهِ, he sees through the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This second part of the hadith is not authentic. So we have to clarify this, although the meaning is true. And inshallah in the future we will talk about the issue of intuition and how it has to do with the heart and how powerful this aspect in human life is. So you are also invited to join us in all the future episodes to learn more about our hearts. So hopefully we will be able to take good care of them, and we will be able to arrive at the key to paradise, the key to ultimate success, the key to the attainment of the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Until we meet next time, I leave you in the care of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Our hearts cry out for